Hi and welcome to my sixth video in the series about enzymes. So today we're going to be looking at some more exam questions. So this first question: enzymes are biological catalysts that change the activation energy of chemical reactions. Explain the meanings of the terms biological catalyst and activation energy. And so one of the first things that you can probably link between these two things is the fact that the biological catalyst, or an enzyme, actually lowers the activation energy. And so that's one mark. Now, a biological catalyst, you've got to define what that term means. So biological, produced from a living organism, hence the biological part, and it speeds up the rate of reaction. So it's a catalyst, that's what the catalyst part is. So biological means from something living or produced from an organism, and it speeds up the rate of reaction. The activation energy is the energy required for a reaction to occur. And what it does is it basically breaks bonds or weakens bonds by increasing the number of collisions. And therefore, you have that's what enzymes effectively do. They lower the activation energy and hence quicken the rate. Okay, B. The graph below shows the results of an investigation into the effect of enzyme concentration on the initial rate of this reaction. So what you can see here is the rate rising and then levelling off at roughly, give or take, that's about 0.175, give or take. So halfway between 0.15 and 0.2. And so explain why it's necessary to measure the initial rate of reaction when investigating the effect of enzyme concentration on the rate of reaction. So some of the ideas that you'll need to come up with here. So the idea that there should be enough substrate molecules to saturate the enzyme. And so in that respect, it's the substrate that's not a limiting factor. And so the reason why you'd measure it at the start is there are lots of substrate molecules there, and therefore that's not having a limit on the rate. So explaining that point would get you 2 marks. The fastest rate, or the fastest increase in rate, is at the beginning, as you can see from the line here. So you could quote that. 4. As the reaction proceeds, the substrate concentration decreases, because what's happening is the substrate is either being metabolized, so it's either being broken down or built up into another product. And so mention the fact that the substrate gets used up by an enzyme or a certain type of interaction, that gains another mark. And 6, the substrate concentration should be constant in each test. So therefore, there's no way of telling if you were to do repeats and you were to measure it at a certain period of time. So let's say 40 seconds in, that you were to get exactly the same concentration of substrate in 2 separate trials. And so therefore, you'd want the substrate concentration to be a constant. Part C. In this investigation, the substrate concentration was a factor that was kept constant. Suggest 2 other factors that should be kept constant. For each factor, state how it can be kept constant. So you basically have to name 2 of the things that need to be kept the same. So these are your control variables. And then you need to say or give an explanation of how they can be kept the same. And so it's any from these. So pH, and you use a buffer solution in order to do that, because we know pH, a high or low pH, can actually denature the enzyme. You need to keep the temperature the same, so probably the most obvious one there is using a water bath. You can't say thermometer there, because the thermometer simply measures the temperature, it doesn't actually control it. The time of the reaction, and therefore you'd use a stopwatch, and you'd use a stopwatch to measure a certain period of time. The volume, so the amount that the enzyme is found in, or the amount that the substrate was found in, specifically not the concentration, but the volume of the liquid added, or the volume of the enzyme added. And the type of enzyme needs to be kept the same, and so therefore you'd use the same batch. Probably the most two obvious ones, or the three most obvious ones, would be pH, temperature and time, and therefore those ones are quite straightforward. You get 1 mark for saying the factor, and then another mark for saying how it's controlled. So for instance, pH 1 mark, buffer another mark.